Deception can be good or bad. It depends on how you use it. Unfortunately, most people use it wrong and end up getting injured. The wrong way to use competition is to go to the gym and try to outlift your workout buddy, or try to lift more than the hot shot next to you just to show him that you're more macho than he is. That kind of testosterone-driven moronic behavior is what gets people injured. A lot of people say that they need to be pushed to work out hard. They need this friendly competition with their workout buddy to push them and motivate them to work out. If this describes you, then I strongly suggest you take a look at your goals. When your goals are properly set, you won't need to be nagged by your workout partner to lift more or do more reps, and you won't need to be slapped till you bleed like some S&M event either. Even in competitive events like powerlifting competitions, it's not you against the others. It's you against you. All that matters is that you lift more weight than you did in the last competition. Why? Because if you improve your personal best in every single competition, you will eventually be the strongest person on the planet without having to compete with anyone other than yourself. Competing against others is a surefire way to lower your self-confidence and pulverize your self-esteem. Why? Because a lot of times you're comparing yourself to your natty friends. Well, guess what? They don't tell you everything. Steroids and performance-enhancing drugs are as illegal as heroin in most countries. They don't know if you're a DEA agent. They're not going to confess. And, you know, what's going to happen when you compare yourself against a fake natty? There's no way you can lift as much as they do. So don't even bother trying to guess if they're natty or not. Because they're not going to tell you, you're not going to find out, so just compete against yourself. Competing against others when you don't know if they're enhanced or not is a surefire way to destroy your self-esteem needlessly. Alles klar? Okay, I mentioned there was a right way to compete. There is. As you might have gathered, it's competing against yourself. All you're trying to do is beat your personal best from last week, last month, last year, whatever the case may be. A member at Sweat for Health came up with an awesome idea for doing this with cardio. So what we're going to do this Saturday, March 19th, we are going to all do a 5K. We're not racing against each other. We're just going to record our benchmark best 5K race time. And then what we're going to do, we're all going to, over the summer, we're going to work as hard as we can to get better. We're going to do interval training. We're going to try to lower our body fat. We're going to put in lots of miles. All these things to try to become better runners. And then mid-summer, we are going to have another 5K race where we try to improve our time. And, you know, it's us against us. No one else is involved. However, to make this a little more friendly competition, I will be giving a Scooby's Workshop t-shirt, a signed one, signed by me, to the person who is most improved. So anyway, if you want to join us, you don't have to join Sweat for Health if you want to do this. I mean, it's great if you do, but you don't have to. Just this Saturday, March 19th, do a 5K. Get your favorite GPS running app on your smartphone. Run 5K, record the time. And then later in the summer, we're going to do it again. And we're going to try to improve. Us against us. The best kind of competition. So that's it. Good competition, bad competition. That's it for today. Auf Wiedersehen.